ओके
यू हैव टू टेक या 11th सम एज होमवर्क फॉर फीफो मेथड. ओके फीफो यू कैन डू इट विथ वेटेड एवरेज मेथड ऑल्सो. सो डू दिस 11th सम विथ बोथ द मेथड्स फीफो एंड वेटेड एवरेज. नोट डाउन प्लीज. 11th सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम ओके विथ फीफो एंड वेटेड एवरेज मेथड. Okay, now we will start with this 6th sum as weighted average method.
Ma'am, apne bole the 5th wale ko weighted average pe karenge.
No, I did not give you beta. I told you weighted average method. You have to wait for weighted average method because only one sum was practiced, no? I told you to wait. It's okay if you have done, not a problem. Okay, so 6th sum. I'm going to start with 6th sum today. 6th question, okay? Shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, write down. See, there is an opening stock on 1st October. And from 3rd October to 31st October, there are purchase and sales transactions. Okay? And we need to calculate closing stock by weighted average method. And you can take the FIFO method as homework. So 6th sum, FIFO method, homework. Weighted average method we are doing now.
Ma'am, 11th and 6th, no ma'am?
11th solved problem, 6th unsolved problem.
Okay.
11th both the methods, FIFO and weighted average. 6th only FIFO method.
Okay.
And after we solve this 6th sum with FIFO method, weighted average method, you take 5th sum as with 5th sum as weighted average method for homework. Do you get my point? Yesterday you have done this 5th sum as FIFO method. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, this 5th sum is done as per FIFO method, no? Yesterday in homework. Now today take this same 5th sum as weighted average method. Do it as per weighted average method. Also, okay, so how many sums in all? 3. 11th sum unsolved problem. 11th sum solved problem with both the methods, FIFO and weighted average. Unsolved 5th problem, weighted average method, method, and unsolved 6th problem, FIFO method. Do you get that?
Ma'am, yes, question ma'am. 5th unsolved.
Yes, this one. Look at my cursor.
Yes, ma'am.
Weighted average. And question number 6, the unsolved FIFO method. Okay. Shubham, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now see question number 6 with the weighted average method. From the following particulars, prepare stock ledger account. We have stock register account by weighted average method. Okay, so draw the lines, write down statement of stock ledger account, statement of stock ledger account, bracket FIFO, bracket weighted average method. Weighted average method. Shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now look at the question. It is the October, it is the month of October 2011. So here we will write October okay, I hope you have drawn the call. You have drawn the columns.
Yes, ma'am.
Date, receipt, issue, and balance. And receipt, issue, and balance will be bifurcated into quantity, rate, and amount columns. First October, opening stock 7,000 units at the rate 3.50 units. So first, we don't have receipts, so receipts will be nil. We don't have issues, so issues will be nil. Right away you have to go to balance column and write 7,000 units into 3.50.
24,500.
Be very careful while calculating the amounts, okay? Next, because this transaction is over, you can draw the line below first date. Now, third date. On 3rd October, you have purchased 12,000 units at the rate 3.80 units per unit. So, this is third date. And you have purchased. So how many units you have purchased? 12,000 at the rate 3.80.
45,600.
So is that okay with everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Issue will be nil. And what about balance? Will you tell me how we will write balance?
7,000.
Very good. First, we have to write 7,000. Its rate is 3.50 and its amount is 24,500. Next, because it is receipt, therefore we will add. Yes, same we will add. How many units? 12,000. And what is the rate of 12,000?
3.80.
And what is the amount? 45,600. But now we have to literally add them, because which is this method?
Weighted average.
Weighted average method. So we need to add both of them. Okay. Now adding will... by adding, it will be 7,000 plus 12,000. Tell me how much it would
19,000.
Be? 19,000. Very good. And yeah, you have to add amount. Okay. 24,500 plus 45,600. How much it would
70,100.
Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now,
yes,
70,100 divided by 19,000. You will get weighted average rate.
3.69.
I will highlight this because this is very important rate. Okay. So 3.69. Okay. Now next. Because this date is over, you can draw the line below third date because the transaction is over. Seventh date, you have sold 13,000 units. The rate is given, but we have to ignore the rate because we will take the weighted average rate. 4.2 is given, but we will not consider that 4.20. We will consider, according to weighted average method, weighted average rate will be considered. So 13,000 units on 7th date. And it is issued. So receipt column will be nil. And issue column, how many units? 13,000, no?
Yes.
So we need to check in the first slot, in the second slot, or directly we can take the help of the total slot.
Final amount.
Yes, the 19,000, the total figure is 19,000. So out of 19,000, 13,000 can be issued very easily. What will be the rate?
3.69.
And that is my weighted average rate. So what is after multiplication 13,000 into
47,970.
Okay. Now tell me what will be the balance.
6,000. Or amount.
How did you calculate 6,000? See, 19,000
minus
13,000.
So you got 6,000 here as a balancing figure. Same way you have to do with amount column.
Amount.
70,100 minus 47,970. So what will be
22,130. 22,130.
Very good. So what will be my rate?
3.69.
Okay. How did you find this 3.69? 22,130. Very good. Divided by 6,000. So it should be 3.69. Otherwise, you are mistaken. Okay.
Wait. Yes.
Just a minute. Yes. Is it now clear, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, which is the next date? After 7th, we have 11th. Purchases 15,000 units at the rate 3.90. So, next date is 15th date. Sorry, 11th date. And we have purchased 15,000 units at the rate
3.90.
So, what will be my amount?
58,500.
58,500. Issue column will be nil, of course. Okay, and now come to the balance column. So what we need to write first?
6,000.
Very good. 6,000 will be written first. And its rate is 3.69. And its amount is 22,130. Now after 6,000, we will add 15,000. Its rate is 3.90 and its amount is 58,500. Now we have to add both of them. Come on, add and tell
21,000.
Yes, very good. So this would be 21,000. And what will be the total of amount?
80,630.
Okay, 80,630. Is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So 80,630 divided by 21,000.
3.84.
Now this is weighted average rate. Is that clear, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next date is 15th date. Sales 17,000 units. So here we will come and write 15th date. Receipt will be nil. Issue will be how many units? 17,000 units. Total in hand we have 21,000 units. Out of that, 17,000 units will be issued at the rate
3.84.
So what is the total answer? 17,000 into 3.84. 20. Repeat again.
65,280.
Okay. So now come to the balance column. 21,000 was there. Out of that, 17,000 was issued. How much is left?
4,000.
Okay. Tell me the total. 4,000.
15. Yes.
Okay, now the amount total means
15,350.
You have to deduct 80,630 from 65,280. So what will be the answer?
15,350.
Now 15,350 divided by 4,000.
3.84.
Did you get now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Let me see this.
okay, no problem. Now, 15th date is over. Now, let me come to 19th date. Purchase 16,000 units at the rate 4.05 per unit. Okay, so we have 19th date here, no? 19th yes, date. How many units are purchased?
16,000
at the rate 4.05. 16,000. 4.05. So multiply both of them and you will get the answer.
64,800.
And what will be my issue?
400.
Oh, issue. Issue will be?
Nil.
Now come to the balance column. What do we need to write first?
4,000.
Very good. So 4,000. Its rate is 3.84 and its amount is 15,350. Okay. Now, because it is receipt, so we need to add on 16,000 units. Its rate is
4.05
and its amount is 64,800. Now add both of them and tell me the total.
20,000.
What will be the amount?
80,150.
And 4.00. Divide. Amount has to be divided by quantity, so you will get weighted average rate. Tell me what it would be.
4.00.
Is that clear? Is it clear?
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Iska na 4.007 aa raha hai, to fir ma'am third digit ko nahi lena hai.
So for, no, yes, you convert, because we want after decimal, okay. We want only two digit. So because it is 7, you will take 1. The second figure,
ma'am,
will be
third digit 7.
Because third digit is 7, so
yes,
second
ma'am.
Digit will be increased by number 1. Yes. So 0 plus 1 means 1.
Yes, ma'am.
So 4.01. Is it now clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now come to the next date, 23rd date. 13,500 units are sold. So here you will write 23rd date. Receipt column naturally will be nil. How many units are issued?
13,500.
You have 20,000 in your pocket. Out of that, 13,500 is gone. At what rate?
4.01.
Huh. So what will be the amount?
54,135.
Okay. 54,135. Now tell me the balance which is left over.
6,500.
Just a minute. Tell me once again, 20,000 minus 13,500. So what will be the total?
6,500.
6,500.
500.
Okay. And what will be the amount? 80,150 minus 54,135.
26,015. 26,015.
Is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
And what is the rate? Divide both of them. 26,015 divided by 6,500. So what is my rate?
4.01.
Match ho raha hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now next, after 23rd, we have 27th date purchased. So here we will write 27th date. Okay. After 23rd, we have 27th date. How many units are purchased? 18,500 at the rate 4.10. So 18,500 in the receipt column, 4.10. What will be the amount? 18,500
into 4.10.
75,850. Is it correct? Yes, ma'am. Okay. Issue column will be nil. Come to the balance column and tell me what has to be written first.
6,500.
Yes, same. It will be copied down. Okay, 26,015. Okay. Now, you have to add 18,500 units, the one that you have purchased today. So, 4.10 is the rate and the amount will be 75,850. Is it clear? Now, add both of them.
25,000.
Ma'am.
Yes.
In date 19.
Yes, tell me.
To 4,093.
Yeah, yeah.
To tell four, me. Balance mein pehle slot mein 4,000 yeah. into 3.84 kar rahe na to 15,360 aa raha hai.
No, what you have to do is 15,350 divide by 4,000. It should be 3.84. Now you check 15,350. See what you have done. 80,630. Calcium mein dalo 80,630. Minus 65,280. So what is your answer? You tell me that answer. Anu, come on, tell me fast.
I'm 15,350.
Yeah. Now divide the same amount with 4,000 units. 15,350 divided by 4,000 units. So what is your rate?
3.84.
That's it. You don't have to multiply now. Okay. You just have to copy down. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Now let's go to the next point. We need to add this. We are on the 27th date. Okay. 25,000. Now we need to add 25,000. Both the units are added. We get 25,000. Now add the amount column.
101,865.
No, I didn't 10,000.
1,01,865.
1,01,865.
65.
Is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
1,01,865 divided by 25,000. So you'll get weighted average rate. 4.07. Okay. Okay. So this will be weighted average rate. Anu, are you getting my point?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, after 27th date, which date we have last? 31st. 15,600 units are sold, issued. So, 31st date, the receipt column will be nil. And issue column will be 15,600 units sold. So, 15,600 out of 25,000. 25,000 we have. Out of that, 15,600 units are sold at the rate 4.07. Okay. Just a minute. It will otherwise create a confusion. Okay. Now tell me what will be the amount? 15,604.07.
63,495.
Mute. Just mute. Yeah, say again. 15,600 into 4.07.
63,495.
Now, the balance column will be reflected by the difference amount between 25,000 and 15,600. So my 25,000 minus 15,600, how much it would be?
Ma'am, 92 RS, 63.4. Yes, ma'am.
92. 63,492
रहेगा. What are you talking about?
इसके कॉलम. इसके कॉलम में अमाउंट.
Here.
Six. नहीं इसको इसके कॉलम में 63,000.
तो दो जन बात कर रहे हैं तो समझ नहीं आ रहा. एक कोई भी एक बोलो.
63,492 रहेगा.
अच्छा 63,492 है क्या?
Yes ma'am.
Is it now okay?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
So 25,000 minus 15,600. What will be my quantity?
9,400.
9,400. And 1,01,865 minus 63,492. So total amount will be
38,373.
38,373. Okay. And what will be the rate? You have to divide both of them and check whether it is 4.07. See, I'll tell you. 38,373 divided by 9,400. So what is the rate? Is it 4.07?
4.08.
It's okay. Not a problem. 4.07, 4.08, not a problem. So it's okay. Is it clear, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Now, because the sum is over, we need to calculate closing stock. So we will write, this month is October, I think. So October, we have closing, we have 31st as a closing balance, closing date. So 31st closing stock, receipt column nil, issue column nil, balance, receipt and issue column will be nil. And what will be our closing stock? 9,400, 4.08
and
38,373. Is it clear, everybody? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So I suppose now you have understood weighted average method also. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you were doing it with me, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You have completed, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So you have to take this sum as homework, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Fifth question will be taken as FIFO method homework. Now the sum that we have done now, sixth sum, that you have to take, in that you have to take FIFO method as homework. Okay.
Yes. FIFO,
and the fifth sum weighted average method, sixth sum FIFO method, and that 11th sum, both methods will be taken as homework. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I think we will practice two sums more for weighted average if you want. The seventh question we will practice as weighted average method. And then I think we can wind up with stock valuation. One more sum I think we should do for the weighted average method so that you gain the confidence for this method also. Now, as you are confident with FIFO method, similarly, I want you to be confident for weighted average method also. Okay, so we will do one more sum,
ma'am.
And then I will be giving you homework. Is that okay?
Okay, ma'am. Yes.
By the next lecture, I mean before your next lecture, you need to complete all your homework sums. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And post it in Google Classroom. Is that okay?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
So that you can check your answers with each other. Yeah?
Ma'am, classroom mein dalna hai homework?
Yes, yes. Google Classroom. okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, shall we wind up for the day?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, bye, ma'am.
Bye, take care. Please do your homework, huh? Don't skip that.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Bye, everybody. Take care.